Hello, you're welcome to my channel. My name is Hannah and I'm a software developer in Ghana. Today I'm going to be sharing with you everything that I learned for my 4 years as a computer science student in KNUST. So stay tuned. I have in my hand my transcript and it covers everything that I learned from level 100 to level 400. And I'm actually amazed about the things that I was learning. No wonder I wasn't even performing in school. Like, I really didn't like about 50% of everything that I was learning. But anyway, don't worry about that. I will touch on every single thing that I did as my undergraduate degree. And we'll see, maybe, just if maybe you still would want to get a computer science degree. My first year, I was doing about 8 courses for first semester and second semester, but let's just see. And so first I was doing information technology 1, circuit theory, which was like a more of like a physics background stuff, and then we're doing introduction to structured program design, discrete maths for computer science, which is actually a good one because it was nice, elements of economics, communication skills, information literacy skills, introduction to pure mathematics. I think that is like the more reason why people in mathematics can easily relate to computer science, because math and computer science, like, they just have a thing. And then the next second semester we came in, we did information technology 2, programming with C++. That's when we really started programming. And then we did discrete math for computer science. Then we did elements of economics, communication skills, which is just like English, then information literacy skills 2, pure maths, and then probabilities and statistics. Like, when I think about probability and statistics, like, I always remind myself of why I wasn't really performing because of this course. Like, this course was just not my friend. Second year, that's when we started with like introduction to electronics, like another physics background. We even had a physics lecturer coming in to teach us that. I think that has to do with mostly those who want to do like them hardware things in computer science. So that's just, I think this whole thing about computer science is like a big field which allows everybody to determine what they really want. Open source operating systems, ethical and legal implication of computing. Do I remember what I was learning? I don't. Linear and numerical algebra, which is also a math background. Object-oriented programming with Java. Yes, that's true. We really started Java in second year. And Java was difficult. Like, seriously, Java was really difficult, at least for me. But it was something, I think one thing about me is that, like, I never feel, but, like, I'm not enjoying it anyway. And then we did system analysis and design. I don't remember that. Database concepts, I do remember we learned database concepts and technologies. Literature in English. Bro, like, was just a 1 credit course, like one credit hour course, but like it was something we just had to do. It's just normal English, it's nothing difficult. So second semester we came in, analog and digital electronics, still physics background, programming with assembly language. Now this one, like, there are times where I think about why we're even learning assembly language. Like, what do we really need that for? Like, nothing. I just pray that those who are doing computer science like in 2020 are not doing assembly language. It's not necessary. No point. There's no way that we are going to use assembly language for anything. Nothing. But I mean, it's education. So for numerical methods and computation, database concepts and technologies 2. I was actually enjoying databases because it was like it was nice. Like, I was really enjoying it. Programming with Visual Basic, yeah. So like, this is like the third programming language that we're doing, because we've done C++, we've done Java, and we are doing VB, Visual Basic. That was actually a very easy one. Like, it wasn't so much like Java. Java was really difficult, literally. and then systems analysis and design, and then literature and English again. So that was just it for first year. In second year, so far the course of computer science is a very broad thing. So like, I think the department tries to touch on every field. So anybody who wants to go into networking, databases, programming, web development, like it's like an all-inclusive stuff. So like, you're literally touching on everything. That's what makes computer science really difficult. Let's continue. So we are moving on to third year. Okay, so third year was really interesting. I can't remember, like it was okay. Accounting, that's when we started accounting one, survey of programming languages. Hey, I remember that lecture, that's true. And then human computer interaction. That's my, I don't know. And then data structures, operations, research. We're doing operations research, it's true. And then introduction to artificial intelligence. See, this one really, I don't even know what to say about all these things that I was learning in school. Seriously, like, I don't know. And then we did web-based concepts in development. I don't remember a thing about all that I learned in third year. Like, literally, maybe data structures. Then the rest, I don't know. So third year, second semester, we did accounting too. Accounting was really a really easy course. I enjoyed it. Computer architecture, computer graphics, e-commerce. I remember we did that, but I don't remember anything about it. And then we did a project. Yeah, so in KNUST, you have to do a project in your third year and then also in your final year. So that's just it. So like we do two projects before we come out of school. So real-time and embedded systems, research method and IT project. Yes, that's like helping you to know how to research. I think that lecturer like was a really good man. Like, he's really into the research stuff and he really taught well. I don't know if I was really learning well. Data structures, we did data structures too, and then operations research, which was actually a good one too. So yeah, moving on to my fourth year. When I was the final year, I was even scared that I even graduated. Like being able to graduate was getting scary to me because I don't know, it's a thing that happens to final year student. Like when you're about to graduate, you feel like you can't complete your project, or like a lecturer will try to like give you a hard time and give you a difficult task to do, and you'll not be able to complete your project, and then you not graduate, and then you have to tell your parents a lot of stories. Like, I was literally going through that. But only for a long while. I think my lecturer, who acted as my supervisor, was actually a good one, and he was always good to me. So, let's start. So, fourth year, first semester, we did data communications, which has to do with, I think that is where we appreciating network more. And then like networking stuff, because we were doing like things around it. And then we did information system. Like, I've mentioned information systems like too many times. I don't know how relevant that is to me anyway. And then we did operating systems, graphic theory and IT applications, introduction to software engineering. Like, we are doing introduction to software engineering in fourth year. Wow, like that's a blow. Expert systems had to do with a lot of reading and stuff, principles of management. Sure. And then that was it. So I think fourth year we're doing seven courses, and then it was good. We had a lot of time because of the project that we're doing, so we're not really going to class like every day. Like, it was every day, but like it wasn't like you were supposed to sit in throughout the day. And then fourth year, second semester, We did just five courses or six courses, and that was computer networks, which also has to do with networking stuff, and then information systems, which I'm mentioning again, and I still don't know its relevance to my life. Introduction to compilers, project, final year project, and then computer security and principles of management. So that is just it about my 4 years in school. So that is just it for my computer science degree for 4 years. I'm not going to sit here to say that getting a degree is not good or is good, but like I always say, like, there are alternatives to be able to get into tech without getting a computer science degree. So if you want to get into computer science, it's good. I would say go for it, but then I'm still going to say there's an alternative for you to get into tech without going through getting a computer science degree. But if you still want to get a computer science degree, you can go ahead, get it, and then be kind of like me, wondering why I learned all these things, because I'm not using any, like, a lot of these things that I learned in school, I'm not applying any of them. But I think there's a thing about computers and having a computer science degree. I don't know, like, it's just a thing. It's like people want to listen to you, and I think probably that's why you're listening, you're watching this video anyway. So I think that's also like a good thing about computer science degree. So that's just it. But thank you for watching this video, and I will see you in my next one. Hit the subscribe button, like this video, share with your friends, tell them that this is a software developer in Ghana trying to blog a story online with the whole world. So stay tuned, and I will see you in my next one. Bye.